Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. This is Marta's Magical Mystery Class, and this is our final NaNoWriMo video, and it is Tarot Tuesday. I had hoped to be able to bring you all a larger tarot spread, and I promise I will here on the channel eventually do some of the larger tarot spreads that I talk about in the books. I've realized there are some personnel and equipment issues involved in effectively making a video of a larger spread. So I'm still ironing those out. Meanwhile, what I'm gonna do for our final NaNoWriMo day and our final Tarot Tuesday is read you a snippet from my first novel, Demeter West and the Ghost Town Glitch, which is about a tarot class. So you can kind of hear how this sort of thing sounds in the context of one of my books. "Yes, Sylvie, that looks good," Demeter said, crouching next to the school desk and smiling reassuringly at the silver-haired woman currently finishing a Celtic cross layout with her tarot cards. "Oh my," said Sylvie, eyes widening as she detected the presence of the dreamy pastel star in the sixth position. Demeter grinned. Sylvie was a matchmaking client she'd recently introduced to a local real estate mogul turned philanthropist, a member of the food bank's board and active in several other local charities. "Things picking up a bit with you and Mark?" Sylvie blushed and shooed her away with a veined hand, anxious to pull out her notebook and start recording tarot impressions. So Demeter stood and stretched, looking over the other students and checking the clock. It was about 8:15. Sylvie was last to have assembled her reading, but the others were all still deep in studying their cards or recording their impressions. Reading the concentration in the room, Demeter headed for the cards waiting at her own desk, navigating, per Casper etiquette, around some of tonight's spectral guests, not entirely banished by the room's intentionally tarot but also ghost-friendly dim light. A pair of boys in breeches and buckskins cooking what looked like gophers over a small fire. Scanning her cards, she was puzzled to see the King of Wands in a reading where he seemed so out of place, and puzzled to see him crossed by death, of all things. 10 minutes left, she thought, as she rose to walk between the rows of desks, still avoiding the ghostly boys. "Rosemary, that's really something," Demeter said, chuckling over an exuberant spread whose caster was carefully taking notes on each card's position as she documented the reading with photos from her iPhone. Rosemary's round face lit up as she lifted her eyes briefly and then returned them to the desk. "I just can't get over how cool this is," Rosemary laughed, shifting back into an awkward stretch in the too small student desk and finally looking fully at her instructor. Rosemary paused, looked down, then addressed the cards. "I mean, that's my life. There's the lady that drives me crazy every day at work," she said, indicating the imposing picture of a very frosty princess of swords. "And here's the restless, I need a vacation voice I keep hearing in my head," she pointed, indicating the fool dangling near the end of the reading's ladder. "I'm so careful all the time, I'm so responsible, and I like that about myself," she hurried to add, when Demeter raised an inquiring eyebrow Rosemary caught out of the corner of her eye. "But the cards are helping me see that there's some other voices in me that I'm not listening to. Voices that want to spend Friday night getting pizza with my sister and her friends instead of staying late at the office. Voices that tell me I have enough saved up I could actually afford to visit Padre Island with my mom, like we've talked about. This has been really good for me," she beamed. "Who knew?" So, that's a little snippet of Rosemary and Sylvie, who are two of Demeter's tarot students out of the first novel, Demeter West and the Ghost Town Glitch. More tarot eventually, and certainly next month in December, more videos about editing your first novel. See you soon. Bye-bye.